matters. And if we don't control our narrative, somebody controls it for us.
We were really excited about having the opportunity to put on a women's leadership symposium. This is obviously something that we get to do via the NCAA Strategic Initiatives Grant, and had a lot of people in our league get behind this early on. Obviously, Ann Goodman James from Colorado College was instrumental in making this happen, and what a great turnout. You know, when we put this together, we weren't sure. When you're doing something during the summer, you know, it's kind of tough sometimes to pull people away from the few months or the few weeks that they get of downtime. But we had a great attendance, great facilitators. I can't say enough good things about Dr. Nicole LaVoy for the Tucker Institute there in University of Minnesota. She was just unbelievable. A rock star is pretty much how I described her. Just so engaging, great information, really eye-opening stuff that she had to share with the group. And then Linda and Raven with Strive Leadership did a wonderful job of facilitating all day the second day, and just provided great information nuggets, you know, great energy. You know, that was the one thing I came across. The walk away for me was what great energy they brought to the table, to the room, and people really did embrace that. And it was just a really good event, great event. First one we've ever done. I'm sure it won't be the last, and I'm just so proud to be a part of it, and looking forward to growing and seeing where this leads us in the future.
It is my pleasure to always speak to a group of women in sport leaders, student athletes, coaches, administrators, because we all have a role in creating social change for women in sport, and it's just my passion to share my knowledge with such a wonderful group.
It's great to have been here these last 2 days and have an opportunity to share and learn with all these amazing women that have come together. Want to really thank our great presenters as they brought out the best in us, I believe. And certainly as, you know, someone who was on the beginnings of this and in talking with our commissioner, Dwayne Hanbury, about the possibilities for this event. You know, I'm really proud of what we've put together and very excited to see us continue to do something like this in the future.
Coming into the symposium this week has been something that I didn't know what to expect. I was really excited about being able to meet people here, though. The networking part of it, being new to the SCAC, is something that I really have enjoyed, and being able to meet the new coaches, meeting the administrators, the student athletes that are involved. It's something that actually coming away from this, I think, is going to be great in our relationship moving forward.
We learned about a lot of different leadership styles, and I learned about other qualities that I can learn to improve myself and how I act towards my teammates to help me get out of my bubble. And I met with so many different people who have different perspectives and encompass those different leadership styles, and they really taught me how to keep myself more well-rounded and be able to approach different types of people who aren't like me.
The most exciting thing for me was being able to be around the different diversity in the group and picking each other's mind, and also knowing the statistics in women's sports and how many there are playing, coaching, and things like that, and how we need to be more involved in that process and speaking up and things like that.
The Women's Leadership Symposium was pretty awesome. I was expecting to come in and learn a lot from it, which I did. I learned an enormous amount of knowledge, not just from the presenters and the keynote speakers, but from the colleagues and people we got to meet. But I think what I wasn't expecting was the level of energy that not just the presenters brought or the Strive group, but everybody here in general. Everybody bought in, and there wasn't a feeling of awkwardness. It was really an environment of just open inclusiveness and really being able to share your opinions while learning from other people and not feeling judged for it. So that was a little unexpected, and I really appreciated that.
I'm so excited to be back in the SCAC for this wonderful opportunity. Being a former SCAC student athlete, I'm super excited that things are still progressing, things are moving forward, and the SCAC has been innovative since I was a student athlete, getting people involved, getting people connected. So to be back in a professional setting and working with people from colleges that I know and recognize has been really incredible, especially in a room full of women that are really ready to continue to take young athletes to the next level. It's been super humbling, but I'm also super proud of everything that's happening here. I could not be more excited for everyone in the SCAC, and it's just been a really great couple of days with everyone here.
All right, so I wasn't really sure what to expect when we came to this. This was the first one that we've been to. I think it's the first one ever, and we weren't really sure what to expect. We didn't know who would be here, how many people would be here, what the topics really were. We got a schedule, but not 100% sure. And the best and most surprising part about it was the energy and the amount of willingness we had from everyone in the different sports, different teams, different schools, to both relate to each other, but also share different experiences and really connect over those different experiences.
So I had a really great time hearing from Dr. Lavoie. She talked about all the she shared a lot of data with us about how women do want to coach, even though the stigma is that women don't want to coach or that we can't coach, but we do, and we do it better.
Hi, this was a lot of fun. I think one of the most exciting and unexpected things here was just getting to meet a lot more people in the same field, especially the same conference, you know, having that commonality and knowing that, you know, I wouldn't have crossed paths with a lot of these women, and hearing their different experiences was a lot of fun. And it's something that is like, okay, we just made 40 new friends in the conference. So I was pretty happy with that.
For me, the most exciting part of the symposium was getting to talk to different coaches, student athletes, and athletic administrators that provided different perspectives on women in sports, and I think I will have a lot of information to take back to Southwestern. Go Pirates!
What I learned about the SCAC is that there's many passionate, vibrant, knowledgeable women in this conference, and what I hope for next year is that the group that's here this year goes back home and recruits all their female colleagues and those who support women in sport to come for the next one. I really want to commend the SCAC for putting resources and time and energy towards putting on this wonderful symposium for women in sport leaders. I wish all conferences around the country would do the same. And so I really want to give them a thumbs up for doing this.